President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. is set to attend the coronation of King Charles III next month. He will be joined by Lady Lisa Araneta Marcos. In a statement, Maracanang said the Philippine first couple have also accepted an invitation to a reception at the Buckingham Palace on May 5th, a day before the big day. The coronation of King Charles III will take place at Westminster Abbey on May 6th. The event is expected to gather world leaders, diplomats, and royals from all over the world.
Malacanang bears the four Philippine locations seen as additional sites the U.S. military can use under the Enhanced Defense Cooperation. Two of the sites are in Cagayan, while the remaining two are in Isabela and Palawan. The palace maintains inspections and assessments were made with the main goal of defending the country's eastern coast. The sites are also seen to boost the country's disaster response. Cagayan Governor Manuel Mamba, who previously opposed the presence of U.S. forces in the province, has urged President Marcos to reconsider the move.
For the U.S. Defense Department, the new EDCA sites will strengthen interoperability between the American and Philippine armed forces. It vows to work in lockstep with the Philippines to pursue modernization at the four additional EDCA sites. The Pentagon also looking at expanding funding in the chosen sites to help boost economic growth in those areas. The Philippines and the U.S. announced the expansion of EDCA sites last February in a move seen as an attempt to counter Chinese influence in the Asia-Pacific region.
Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has put on hold the dismissal of his defense chief. That's according to a source cited by Reuters. Netanyahu and defense chief Yoav Gallant even made a public appearance together Monday evening during a visit to a military base. Netanyahu announced he was firing Gallant on March 26 after the defense official called for a halt to the government's flagship justice overhaul. The announcement led to protests, forcing Netanyahu to hold off both sacking Gallant and the controversial judicial reforms.
Finland's flag set to be raised at the NATO headquarters on Tuesday as the country officially joins the military alliance. Finland, along with Sweden, asked to join NATO last year in response to Russia's invasion of Ukraine. The Northern European nation has a 1,300-kilometer border with Russia. This means NATO's frontier with Russia will roughly double in length. Moscow has vowed to beef up its forces in border regions.
This is a historic week. We will welcome Finland as the 31st member of NATO, making Finland safer and our alliance stronger.
In other news, former U.S. President Donald Trump now in New York City to face charges stemming from a probe into hush money paid to an adult film actress. Trump is due to surrender at the Manhattan District Attorney's office Tuesday. He will likely be fingerprinted prior to appearing before a judge for an arraignment where he will plead not guilty. Trump's lawyer maintains his client is innocent.
He's gearing up for a battle. You know, this is something that obviously we believe is a political persecution, and I think people on both sides of the aisle believe that, that it's a complete abuse of power.
Trump, a 76-year-old Republican seeking to regain the presidency in 2024, is the first former U.S. president to face criminal charges. Another Ukrainian city could be added to the UNESCO World Heritage List. President Volodymyr Zelensky on Monday met with the head of the UN body to discuss the potential inclusion of the historic city of Cherniv on the list. The two also discussed efforts to further protect Ukrainian cultural sites amid Russia's invasion. UNESCO estimates the invasion has led to $2.6 billion in damages to the country's cultural sites. Reconstruction efforts could amount to nearly $7 billion.
I can imagine the toll, the human toll of war and all you're going through, but I appreciate that you take, you give importance to the human dimension of it through the protection of culture and education, because we know that it defines Ukraine as a nation, and it is our mission in UNESCO to be on your side, to be on the side of the Ukrainian people, to protect this cultural heritage.
Back in January, the Ukrainian port city of Odessa was added to the UNESCO World Heritage List.
Relatives mourn the deaths of two Filipino-American servicemen who died in a helicopter crash in Kentucky last week. The story from our North America correspondent, Steve Angeles.
The promising lives of two young Filipino-American service members came to a tragic halt last Wednesday. Sergeant Isaac John Gallo, known as Kevin, and Corporal Emily Maria Eve Bolanos were among the nine U.S. Army soldiers of the 101st Airborne Division who died in a helicopter crash during a night training session in Kentucky. The cause of the crash involving two Black Hawk helicopters remains under investigation. Gallo's only relative is in the U.S., his sister Margarita, who now finds herself alone in mourning. The two immigrated from Laguna Province in the Philippines to Los Angeles 10 years ago.
Nagsimula kami ng walang-wala. Lahat sinacrifice ko, mapatapos ko lang siya.
In those 10 years, while going back and forth to complete college in the Philippines, Kevin worked at a local Filipino grocery, an amusement park, and for the school district. He joined the U.S. Army in 2019, believing it would fast-track his U.S. citizenship while offering a number of benefits along with a bright future.
Marami siyang dreams. Gusto niya maging piloto. Gusto niya lahat masubukan niya. Graduate siya ng computer engineering. And then, trabaho siya. Gusto nung ma-enlist siya sa Army as mechanic. Then, sabi niya, mag-aaral ako. And then, nag-take siya ng master's degree. Then, sabi niya, ate, I want to be a pilot. Then, okay. Sabi ko sa kanya, ako saan ka masaya, susuportahan kita.
Margarita remembers her brother for his hard work and his positive attitude. The siblings had just bought a house and were set to move in this month before the tragic crash.
Yung kapatid ko is sobrang caring niya, sobrang loving niya. Ayaw niya nang umiiyak yung mga kapatid ko, and then especially my mom. Then lahat ng tulong na hingin mo sa kanya, ibibigay niya kahit mahirap. Lagi siyang nakasmile, never mo siyang makikitang nagagalit.
His loss is especially hard on her after they lost their father 2 years ago. The 27-year-old Kevin was supporting their mother along with his two other siblings back in the Philippines. Margarita has set up a GoFundMe in the hopes of continuing his support for their loved ones at home.
Yung binimake sure niya na okay yung family ko. Lahat na bibigay niya, kahit walang wala na siya. Basta maibigay niya lang lahat ng gusto ng family ko.
In the meantime, the mother of Corporal Emily Bolano spoke to DZMM's Teleradio as she was trying to secure visas and passports for Emily's brother to travel to the U.S. Emily, whose father lives in Las Vegas, moved to the U.S. 6 years ago at age 17. She enlisted in the U.S. Army in 2019 after attending high school in the U.S. where she became a Black Hawk mechanic. Last year, at age 22, she purchased a home in Tennessee where she was planning to bring her mother to join her in the U.S. Bolanos was scheduled to be promoted to sergeant on April 1st, just days after her untimely death.
Marami siyang trabaho dun sa U.S. Army at saka napaka-dedicated niya. Hindi ko alam kung saan ang gagaling ang dedikasyon niya. Kunin na po ako. Sana, in fact, na i-file na niya yung petition sa akin. Hindi ko alam po kung ano-anang ang status ko ngayon.
Philippines Department of Foreign Affairs explained that while they're assisting in securing a passport for Emily's brother, they have no jurisdiction over a U.S. visa. However, they are optimistic that the U.S. government will be able to expedite their visa due to the circumstances. Salcedo has been in contact with the U.S. Army, and they've also informed her that her daughter will be promoted to sergeant posthumously. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.